Several months ago, we posted a teardown video of DJI 100W dual USB-C GaN power adapter. It can charge your drones and remote controller at the same time. Since it supports PD and PPS, you can also use it to charge your phones, tablets, or even laptops. Except for the charger, it also comes with two cables. The length of this detachable power cord is about 1 meter. As for the other dual USB-C cable, it's also about 1 meter. Our charger that powers ZKM003C shows it supports 100W and USB 2.0. Back to the charger, it adopts a black square design with DJI logo on the top center. This is the AC input socket, and two USB-C upper ports are on the other side. The specs info is printed on the button, model is CDX265-100. It can support input of 100-240V, 50 or 60Hz, 2.5A. The USB-C 1C2 can provide up to 100W output. The manufacturer is Honor Electronic. The size of the adapter is about 73.5 by 70 by 32mm. The total weight is about 275 grams. And the power density is about 0.61 watts cubic centimeter. The charger that powers ZKM003C shows it supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, PD 3.0, PBS, QC 5 protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed speeds of 5V, 3A, 9V, 12V, 15V, 20V, 5A, and a set of PBS. We found the maximum power can be around 85 watts when charging a single device. With QC 5 protocol, the Nubia Z30 Pro is faster than the MacBook Pro. Unfortunately, it cannot trigger the TV mode of switch. When charging two devices at the same time, the power can be divided into 48 watts and 42 watts. The total upper power won't exceed 100 watts. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro. The voltage is always around 20 volts. The charging curve can be divided into four parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 93 watts from 17 minutes to 43 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 70 watts and 44 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 9 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 56 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. The charger can charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro to 50% in 33 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 57 minutes, 100% in 1 hour and 56 minutes. The last 20% took nearly half of the total time. We also use it to charge the iPhone 14 Pro. The voltage can be around 9 volts at the beginning, and the charging curve can also be divided into 5 parts. The peak power is 20.4 watts at 17 minutes, then the power gradually drops to 16 watts, 11 watts, and 6 watts in turn. At 48 minutes, we can clearly see the voltage drops to 5 volts, but the current increased. It takes 2 hours and 2 minutes to be fully charged. So you can charge the iPhone 14 Pro to 50% in 24 minutes, and can reach 80% in 51 minutes, 100% in 2 hours and 2 minutes. Since the Apple 20W only needs 1 hour and 45 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 14 Pro, it's slightly slower. As for the standby power part, the power consumption at 220 volts, 50 Hz is 0.066 watts and 0.019 watts at 110 volts, 60 Hz, which is about 0.578 and 0.166 kilowatt hour in 1 year respectively. It's much lower than most chargers in all of our standby power tests. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 75.87% to 91.41% at 220 volts, 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 75.91% to 89.61% at 110 volts, 60 Hz. This is why this 100 watts charger can only charge up to 90 watts when charging two devices at the same time. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple without load. When the output is 20 volts, 0 amp, the lowest ripples are around 25 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 9 volts and 12 volts, the highest ripple are around 70 millivolts peak to peak. then move to the ripple test when loaded. The over ripples are lower than without load. When the output is 15V, 5A, the highest ripple is 22 and 23.2 mV peak-to-peak respectively. When the output is 5V, 3A, the lowest ripple is 11.6 and 12 mV peak-to-peak respectively. So in most cases, this ripple can be controlled very well. We also put the charger into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test. After an hour of 100 watts output, we got the maximum temperature. Under 220V, 50Hz, the front is 56.3 degrees Celsius and the back is 68 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110V, 60Hz, the maximum temperature on the front and back is 64.3 degrees Celsius and 65 degrees Celsius, respectively. It's relatively hot, but still complies with the IEC 62368 standard. Well, that's all our tests for this 100W dual USB-C charger from DJI. In addition to charging your drone and remote, the 100W PD protocol also makes it compatible with your phone and laptop. Two identical USB-C ports can realize automatic power distribution. You don't need to judge which is faster. It shows good performance in standby power consumption and ripple tests. However, the conversion efficiency and temperature are not as good as we expected. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!